it's Joe with Quick Flix, and round two, same day. So I'm 2 1/4 way through of my commitment. Except I didn't realize that tomorrow's Father's Day and my daughter's birthday, so I might not be able to do the 5 that I said, but you never know. Anyway, what I'm working on now is a gender reveal, and it's wheels or heels. And this is the little girl for the heels. She's a Divine Digital Diva image. Again, that's Divine Digital Diva on Etsy. I'm going to do a little bit of glittering on here. Not a lot, because there's some other stuff I'm going to be doing to her. I'm using my Nouveau glitters because I ran out of pink on my stickles. And I've not been extremely busy this year or the past few months or so. Well, I shouldn't say I've been busy. I haven't been having much work, and which has been good because of my son and his open heart surgery, and my husband's had a issue, and you know, there's always a reason that something intervenes or someone intervenes when you're needed most. I don't know if I said that right, but I know what I mean. I forgot to mention that my father, who is 98 years old and still wittier than unbelievable, just to talk to him on the phone, you'd never guess in a million years that he was 98 years old. However, he is an avid hunter, fisher, golfer, the whole gambit, always has been. And he was having knee issues some years ago. I'd never knew about it until more recently, and he needed knee replacement, both knees. However, my father, it was not a convenient thing for him to do because it was going to cut into either fishing or hunting or golfing, or so he just said he'd just put up with it. So he didn't have the surgery done. Well, now he's 98 and should have had the surgery done, and he'd be doing fantastic. But he made a poor choice, didn't have it done, so he uses a walker now. He's in fantastic health and can still drive. Everything is just sharp as a tack. But now he uses a walker and is having a lot of trouble with his knees. Well, a week and a half ago, he always sits down when he gets dressed or puts anything over his hat, a sweater, a t-shirt, whatever, and I have no idea why, and I don't think he has any idea why either. He decided to stand while he put his, what he said, sweater on, and fell over. So anyway, he broke his hip. And when he got into the hospital, and they did surgery the following morning, and put a pin, screw, whatever, into his hip, and said, well, in a couple hours after he woke up, that they would try and get him up to walk. So when I talked to him, he was waiting, or when I talked to my stepmom, she was waiting for them to get back to let her know, you know, when they're going to get up walking. She was keeping me up to date with everything. And I've got to tell you, it's Nouveau pink glitter outline of the shoe, and on these shoes, they've got some, I don't think you can see them on the camera. My lighting bites, but there's star like bursts. I did those in the glitter instead of, I didn't do the whole thing. I just did those stars so they popped out more. But anyway, now I'm going to outline the gold crown in gold glitter. And I forgot to look for gems. So I'm trying to be more prepared so I can shorten my videos and not take so much time dinking around trying to find what I need. So far, I'm not sure how that's working for me. Anyway, my father, they got him up to walk. He's in a lot of pain to walk. And so they ended up transporting him last Friday. Well, was it last Friday? Yeah, last Friday, to rehab facility that's probably about 20 minutes from where they live. I forgot to put the glossy accents in her eyes. please fall face up. And it did. Sweet. Don't want it to ruin anything. Oh, golly. I'm trying to hurry. I need to slow down. They transported him to a facility that isn't too far away. And I've been calling to kind of catch up and make sure, you know, every day how he's doing. And when I talked to him yesterday, I get the details from my stepmom and then just get to say hi to him, because he's usually in the middle of rehab when I call. They do it all day long, so I always manage to interrupt him. But anyway, I probably talked to him maybe 5 minutes, and he said he was exhausted and needed to go. Haven't gone to see him yet. He didn't want us to come up, my brood, until he was able to visit, because he didn't want us wasting a trip. I don't know why he'd called that a waste, but I didn't think he was going to be there more than a day or two. And every time I talk to him, it's a little bit longer. So at this point, I think I'm just going to drive down anyway. Now, this one's dry. So what I'm going to do on her, she's got the little tutu on and the pearls. So I'm going to go ahead and put my pink tutu on her. And glue gun is on and fired up. I don't know how I got on that about my father falling. But anyway, he did. Broke his hip. Because I guess I'm usually giving some kind of update what's been going on in my family. My new grandchild is due in 8 weeks. And don't anybody ask me what it is, a boy or a girl, because this particular son and daughter-in-law never find out. They like the element of surprise, which I do too. I think that's really cool. However, I don't really like it when the time comes, because I, or not when the time comes, during, because I really want to know what it is. And, but this is their fourth and they've done this every time. So I'm handling it pretty good. Those scissors aren't cutting. Probably cut too many items that I couldn't cut with scissors. So I didn't cut that off soon enough, and my glue dried. I'm going to put 2 layers of the ruffle on her. I don't know where I was going with that, guys. I think I was talking about just things going on in general that have been keeping me extremely busy. Tomorrow is my daughter's birthday and Father's Day, so I totally forgotten about that. And my kids are all going to come over for cooking and a cookout and swimming. And I know a lot of people that ask me. I just had my 50th wedding anniversary a couple weeks ago. Poor man. We married 50 years. I about worn him out. But anyway, a lot of people asked me what I was going to do. And, you know, we need to go somewhere special. We need to travel. We need to Well, I was married for 6 years before we had children. We'd been together 9 years. And we traveled. I lived overseas. I traveled overseas. I did pretty much all the traveling I wanted to, because I don't like to fly. So I wasn't all gung-ho about any of it. But I know a lot of people, a lot of my friends are traveling. I think one of them possibly sold their house and don't even have a home anymore, because they're, every time I look at their, or every time I get their news feed, what's going on with them, they're in another country or wherever. They're what you call living the dream. It's just not my dream. And don't get me wrong, anybody, because for those that like it, good for you. And I hope you can, those of you that hope to do that one day, I hope you can. But anybody that thinks I'm missing out, because I don't, it's a choice. I don't like to travel and at all. My last trip, when I went to Mexico, I went scuba diving, which was an experience. And now I think my next thing on my bucket list is to skydive. My granddaughter just went, and now I have this bug that I want to go skydiving, but I don't want to travel. So my husband and I are talking about going skydiving together. Somebody said, what if you splat? And I said, well, at least we'll go together. So, don't know if we'll do it, but not real sure if he would be able to, given the different heart issues he's had. However, they've not been related to a bad heart, but because of high cholesterol, and I don't think skydiving is going to give him a clot that he didn't already or may not have already had. I don't know. We wouldn't do it without talking to the doctor first. So that is something that I think would be quite spectacular. We'll just see. I don't like to fly, so I don't know why I had this thing that I'm going to go skydiving. Okay, I put the beads on her around, and then I had to cut it because it's just a short piece up here. And let me do that one. There we go. There we go. And let me see, I got that size all done with the glitter and everything. Okay, so let's do this one. Let's do this one. Now, when I start it, I go about an inch up from the bottom of it because I'm going to make two layers, but I don't want them close together. I just want it to make it thicker. So I go about mid of the little tutu she has on. And oopsie, a little crooked on that line. Now, I cut it off a little bit longer so that I can fold back the edge when I glue it down so that I don't have a raw edge of the ruffle here. Except it would help if I had glue on it. That would help a lot. Okay. I have a challenge now that I got on Thursday at my gym. I was picked member of the month last month at my gym for hard work and consistency. I thought that was very nice, very kind. But anyway, the manager or assistant manager there, she's 30 years old, and then one of the women in my class is 70, and I'll be 72 in a couple weeks. We're in a challenge. I don't know whose idea it was that who's going to be able to do a chin-up first, because you kind of set a goal. This is what I would love to achieve. I don't think I've ever done a chin-up in my entire life. I may have, but I don't remember. So I work on the assisted pull-up chin-up machine. And we've challenged each other to push to do it without assistance. And I told the young lady that did this challenge, I've got 50 years on her. And her remark was that she had 50 pounds on me. Thought that was a funny answer, but so she said she had more weight than she had to pull up, so she thought it was all fair. But guys, that is my goal that I'm working on now, and do the splits. I bought a hyperbolic tape on working out, stretching, because a lot of the, when I go to work out at the gym in my classes, a lot of the things that we have to do, even for warming up or cooling down or whatever, involve a lot of stretching. And stretching is probably not one of my best suits. So I decided to practice at home using this tape, this video that I bought. And I was talking to my son and daughter-in-law about it yesterday, and they said, oh, come on, you're never going to be able to do it. And I'm thinking, well, you're right, but I'm not going to toss in the rig yet. But my daughter-in-law, who is 9 months pregnant, was asking me to see how far I could go. We're out at the pool, and she said, how far can you go on the splits? I said, man, I'm still working on the stretching. But my son said he could foresee me being hospitalized doing the splits and going to have surgery putting me back together. And I'm going to have to go with what my son said. Probably that is where I'm going to end up. I don't know if I'm ever going to be able to do that. But I watch all these videos of these women and they're 80. And one today that I watched of a woman working out, she was 102 years old. And she was just fantastic, her health-wise. Okay, these are going to go on a box. Again, the last one I did was on a box as well. Except I don't know if I cut enough to do pink all the way around. I think I did. I'm going to put a pink one together. Uh-oh. What was wet there? Huh. Oh, it isn't. That's glitter. Because I put it right on top of my just recently glittered piece that now I'm going to have to redo. Duh! Boy, I wasn't paying attention. I guess I didn't mess it up. It had started to dry enough that, nah, I guess I didn't do any damage. I take it back. Take it back. Okay. Now, I am going to tape up my box here. When I'm taping the side that has the cover on it and I leave it open, I like to go each direction, which is only two, and go all the way across the entire box. So I have my tape, except for my diagonal right here, all set on all three of these squares. There we go. I did not do, okay, I only have two. So I should have one, two, three, four. One, two, three. I need to cut another sheet because I don't think I was going to do pink up here. I think I was going to do white. But that's okay. I can cut it and add it onto the box since I'm only going to do one right now anyway. And the pink is more picking up the darker pink in the shoe than the lighter pink like she has on. Really make it pop out because I'm going to also be putting the image on top that's well, I'll show you what it says. And there we go. I'm going to go out and do my virtual workout as soon as I'm done here that I absolutely love. But now in the summer months when I go and do it in the garage and it's hotter than blazes out there. I have a heat stroke. So I'm trying to put it off for as long as I can. Now it moved up an eighth of an inch. Maybe it didn't. I don't know. I can't tell. I forgot to get the blocks out. I forgot to get my blocks out, guys. One, two, three, four. Good thing my husband's works in wood. We don't have to waste much of anything. We have too much of everything, but we don't have to waste it. Okay, I'm going to put my black in there. These are just scraps of 2x2s. Any wood, you just want to make sure that the wood that you put up here to reinforce and to hold your image is able to hold. If you have an 18-inch image in there or a larger one, like this is larger, there is thinner wood that's like a half an inch. I can use that, but I don't use that if I'm using a bigger sized image because it's not sturdy enough. I want it so they sit firm. For her, I made the little girl little to put on the front of the box. And this one says heels down here. Because remember, this is wheels or heels. Whoop. And I love these gender reveals. They're so cute. However, I don't think I've ever had in my family, I don't think we've ever had a gender reveal party. As a matter of fact, I do believe the only one that had a gender reveal was actually just for the siblings. They had a gender reveal just for them. We had dinner over there and they did it for the kids to find out if they were having a brother or a sister. And I remember my granddaughter, it was a boy, and I remember my granddaughter got up from the table and she said, I knew it. She wanted a sister really bad, so she was a little disappointed. She was young, so, you know, she wasn't thinking, well, tell, she wasn't thinking anything. She was just thinking she wanted a sister. And it was a boy. And then when they had the next one, it was a boy again. So she was kind of let down a couple times. Now they finally got a girl, so now she has a little sister. And I'm glad she got another girl, so. Okay, there we have the box. And this is the piece that I just did. And I think I mentioned in the last film, when you're gonna put them on the box, open it and hold it by the chunk of wood and twist it in. What happens if they go in, you want them to go in tight so that it stays really good. If you push it, you push the box lid in. There we go. There's the little girl in the heels. Oh, I forgot to put the heels on the back. The back. I'll do it right now. And then we're going to do the little boy. I'll pause this for a minute while I get this taken care of and be right back with you. Okay, I'm back again. I got the other box done for the little girl, and now I'm going to show you the little boy. And here's my box. What to do with my glitter paper. Oh, right here. Oh. Okay, this one's going to be in blue. Okay, uh-oh. Somebody must be coming near my house. About the only one that comes near my house. Oh, poo. I ran out. I'm going to have to pause, guys. Okay, guys. I just had to change the tape in my tape gun here. So, sometimes that might take me a little bit. It doesn't always want to work with me kindly. Let's see here. I keep hearing lawnmowers going outside my window. One was my husband just mowing, but now all the neighbors are mowing. Love that sound, because that means it's summer. And kids are all out of school, so I am busier than a cranberry merchant on Thanksgiving Day. The other day there were 15 kids over here to swim and plan the trampoline and do whatever. And my daughters were here handling, you know, feeding them and whatever. But I ended up having to come in the house because I can get so stressed out when they get playing. I mean, there's just times that I think, oh, I'm just too old for this. My heart can't take it. So whenever they come over, I tell you guys, come over whenever you want. I don't care. I have no issues whatsoever. However, don't get upset if I leave the party or if I don't even join the party, because they bring over friends. And somebody asked me, do I provide them with all the food and drinks and all that work and everything? Do I do that? You know, and I don't know, asking. And some people probably might wonder. No, I do not. My kids are grown, and my kids are great at, between them all, providing the food, providing the extra cost of heating the pool, and chemicals and everything like that. They do not just take it for granted. They all contribute to the cost of our summers, because with as many of them as we are, it can get very, very, very costly. And no, I do not babysit on my own. If I'm going swimming, I only have 3 of the little ones 2 days a week, and 5 days a week I have 1 of the little ones that I actually provide care for and have been forever. I mean, all of them I have before they start school. Those days, if I have just them, I will take them swimming if I have just the 2 when the baby's down for a nap. Otherwise, if I don't have another adult here, we do not go swimming. It's just not a safe thing to do. So, but my son and daughter-in-law that have the two little ones that I take care of 2 days a week for the day, 8 hour days. They're also looking for number three. Haven't found them yet. They're still looking, but they went on vacation for 2 weeks. Well, they went on vacation for a week, but it happened to fall. The days that it fell means that I'm not going to have the two-year-old and the three-year-old, she's almost four, for 2 weeks. It's kind of like a little bit of a break for me. So I decided to take advantage of that time and get some work done, because I usually don't have time for much work. My time, my free time is non-existing. Oh, the tape didn't stick. This must have been where I ran out of tape and didn't realize I didn't come to the... Ow! Ooh, my knee just went out. Been having issues with my knee and with my ankle. I believe I have tendonitis in my Achilles heel. I have a doctor's appointment. I have numerous doctor's appointments. I'm at that age now where you have to have a oil change about every 3 months. Seems like every time I turn around, I've got to go to the doctor for something. Not health-wise, but to make sure I stay that way, healthy. So I have to have my ankle and my knee checked. I had knee surgery on this knee years ago, and I'm not going to do it again. I will put a brace on it and fight the pain. Just want to see if there's some physical therapy I can do. Working out probably doesn't help, but that is why I do rebounding, which is very low impact versus a lot of the heavy-duty jumping in my class. I don't do it. I do a different option because of my knee. I do not want to forego any sort of surgery again. You do what you got to do, but I'm telling you now, chances are slim to none that I'm going to do it. I'll be like my dad. I'll wait till I'm 100. There we go. And there is the little wheels. Down here it says wheels. I will take some close-up pictures. I didn't show you glittering him because I'd already had him done. There's a little bit of the blue on the blue of the bike, and then I added silver to just have some of the parts pop out, and there was a couple red pieces on there, and I did the same image down here. So we have the wheels and heels done. I will get the pictures, and hopefully my internet will be working with me tomorrow or tonight, and I'll be able to get these uploaded. I have 1, 2, 3 more to do. This one I'm just going to be showing glittering, but these two I'm going to try and get uploaded right away. But thank you for watching. Happy Father's Day, and everybody have a safe remainder of your weekend. Bye-bye.